Next Thursday, DotArt will hold its 8th annual fundraiser at the historic First Parish Church on Meeting House Hill in Dorchester. The annual snazzy, jazzy, arty party will feature a silent auction of pieces by local artists, live jazz, a Cape Cod catered raw bar, and lots more. Joining me now is Liz Carney, the executive director of DotArt, Provincetown gallery owner, and an artist and arts educator in her own right. It's good to see you again, Liz.
Nice to see you, Chris.
All right. First of all, for those people that maybe don't live in the Dorchester area, what or who is DotArt?
Well, DotArt is an organization that has been around since 1998. It actually started a little bit earlier than that, in the early 90s, and was incorporated in 1998. And by a group of citizens in Dorchester and an art educator who was interested in bringing art education to children. And then slowly over time, DotArt grew and it's in a new iteration. And
right, it's had various different studios, like a pottery studio. You guys have been in the Dorchester Day Parade and stuff like that. But we're talking about the snazzy, jazzy, arty party. Right. Now, first of all, where did that name ever come from?
I believe when it was created many years ago, I think 8 years ago, it came from one of our children.
Okay.
And DotArt works with children ages 3 to 10, and so it sort of had a youthful sound.
Right, and that's why the big, bright colors and things in your logos. All right, now tell us about the what's going to be happening next Thursday, your big fundraiser.
Okay, well, we're going to have a silent auction of artists from Dorchester, from Boston, from Greater Boston, nationally, and even a couple international artists. We have some really great auction items. In addition to that, like just today, a wonderful author named Courtney Sullivan, who wrote the book Commencement and is from Milton, and, you know, right across the river. She's donated.
The Neponset River, yes.
Yeah, she's coming out with a new book, and so she's donated an opportunity. She'll come from New York, where she lives now, to visit with people who put together a little book club, and she'll auction off her time to talk about her book and sell
right, you
copies
have pieces
of her,
by Corita Kent, Sister
exactly.
The iconic Dorchester gas tank.
Yeah, we have Eugene Richards' book, Dorchester Days. Like, you know, some of the items that we have are specific to the arts and culture of Dorchester, like the John F. Kennedy Library Museum is donating from one of its curators a private tour of the museum, which is really
great.
Wonderful.
Like,
because Dorchester people forget that we have some really important cultural institutions right in our own backyard. So
now you have your own gallery in Provincetown, and that's where a lot of the food is coming from.
Exactly.
You're well known down there, and so how did you ever convince them to cater the food up here?
Well, I've worked in youth arts education for about 20 years, and for many years I had, for several years, I had a position at the Provincetown Art Association and Museum working with youth programs there. And one of the students at the Provincetown Art Museum, who's gone on to study art now in college, his dad owns Cape Tip Seafood. And he just really thinks that it's great that, you know, art education really makes a difference.
Right, and you've also got support, of course, from the many fine Dorchester restaurants that are giving.
Exactly, and you know what's amazing is that growing up in Dorchester, going to Provincetown was a really unlikely place coming from Dorchester and going to Provincetown.
But your mother is a watercolorist, is that,
yes.
Is that there? Is
yep,
that...
my mother took us to Provincetown every summer. She had gone to art school, and there's a great art community in Provincetown, and so
this is a Dorchester-Provincetown connection.
Yeah, and so this is really not an unusual connection to see, you know, a great arts community in Massachusetts coming to help a sort of budding arts program in Dorchester.
And so, finally, the music, that's also sort of a family affair, at least partially.
Partially. Yeah. We have, although we're hoping Grace will Grace is my brother's daughter, and hopefully Grace Carney will actually grace us with her presence. But she's performing in Provincetown in Ryan Landry's show this summer, and so she was going to come up and do a number, but her two brothers will be playing with us, as well as Chris Middleton from Dorchester and John Margaris, and they're all Dorchester youth who are really excellent performers.
All right, so that's it. many of the Dorchester arts organizations are expanding beyond, say, the visual or performing arts and trying to make, you know, an evening, especially a gala evening like yours. Now, what do you want to say about the First Parish Church, their hospitality, and that's where Open Studios also happens, yes. Right? So Art Lavoie sure. is the minister there, right?
Sure, and it's an amazing congregation. As many of you know, it was one of the five congregations that started Harvard University. It's one of the oldest congregations in the United States, and First Parish Church is also under construction, and they're rebuilding, and I look at it kind of wonderfully because DotArt is rebuilding. After, you know, a recession and a hard time financially, we're trying to rebuild, and the church is under scaffolding right now. So we're going to be having our party in a church that's literally under construction.
Without a steeple. Even though it's historic.
But it's a beautiful space with high ceilings and crown molding. It's just got great bones. It's a great church. So.
All right, let's talk a little bit about the programming that you guys have planned for the kids.
Okay.
What kind of class? I know you got to always adjust to the whims of the parents and the times there.
Sure. Well, we have classes in our two studio locations. We have a studio in Savin Hill area, which is through a partnership with College Bound Dorchester. And then we have a studio in the Walter Baker Lofts on the other end of Dorchester. And we have a partnership in between with the Henderson School. And we actually just had a great meeting at the Mather to try to reach out and start working in their after-school program. And we've done collaborations with, you know, other arts groups like, you know, Boston City Singers. We had our teachers
which are
come
in Dorchester at Ashmont.
Right, right. So, like, our teachers went in and facilitated last year a great collaboration where we helped the students illustrate Langston Hughes poems, which they were also setting to music. So it was this really beautiful synergy of, like, art and poetry and music all coming together, and it's just a really
just encouraging
really
them
great,
to be creative and yeah. wherever their talents lie.
Yeah, and we also do art events where we just went to the Dorchester Hometown Comfort event where we had 150 students do a drop-in project that was assembled into one large circle painting, which is almost like a mandala, which then got repurposed and brought down the Dorchester Day Parade. So it's important that people see that art can happen anywhere. There's a lot of talk about pop-up art and pop-up museums, and I think galleries and DotArt really is an agile organization that can show up quickly and put together an art event that provides meaning and provides connectedness and community with not a lot of resources, really. I mean, we do it pretty much on a low budget. So,
what's the takeaway message here? Is how can people, where can they find out information about ticket prices?
Sure.
And this is
definitely the party's going to be a great time. www.art.org is our website. You can buy tickets right online. And really just take away that art matters. Art's for everyone. Art in Dorchester's growing. We have the Dorchester Arts Collaborative doing great work. We have DotArt doing great work. We have, Boston City Singers and all the, you know, a host of artists that are cropping up in open studios. It's just a really good time.
All right. So, well, and speaking of good times, we want people to head
out.
Come
to our
next
party.
Thursday.
Thank you.
Thanks, your
Thank
arty
you so
party.
Much.
Okay.
Okay.